Hello everyone and welcome back to Chicano Cinema. This week you are going to see the true beginning of Chicano cinema. This film is called Zoot Suit. Now Zoot Suit was written and directed by Luis Valdez. Luis Valdez was the son of migrant farm workers and he got into Stanford and got his degree in theater. Like all of us, when you get your degree, you're like, what do I do with this? Well, he went home and he noticed the living conditions that his parents were in, and they were similar to that of the film you just saw, Salt of the Earth. And he looked at them and he said, you know what? I want to do something about this. So he started a theater troupe and he teamed up with Cesar Chavez and he and his brother Danny Valdez, and Danny is the lead in the film. So the person who is the lead character in the film you're about to watch wrote all of the music for the picture, and he also was one of the main actors in Teatro Campesino. What they would do is they would all hop in a flatbed truck and they would drive out into the fields. If Cesar Chavez couldn't get a group of field workers to unionize, they would send in Teatro Campesino. And Teatro Campesino would drive into the field and they would put up this little sign, and it said Teatro Campesino on it, and it was just riddled with bullet holes. They had to put on a 3-minute play. And they would hop out of the truck and they would gather all of the field workers around, and they would have one of them stand up and do an impression of their boss. And they put a pig mask on them. And then the actors would pretend to be the field workers. And just in doing that, in allowing one of the workers to make fun of their boss, they were able to diminish the power and the stranglehold of that group enough to allow the workers to unionize. They'd have to do a play in 3 minutes or less because they were doing what was called guerrilla theater. Now, guerrilla theater is where it is as dangerous for the people performing it as it is for the people watching it. They would have to perform their play, hop in the truck, and drive off because they were also trespassing. So as they're driving off, they're being shot at, and that's why all of the signs had bullet holes. As soon as he came home, he went, all right, well, now I've changed the world with my degree. Now what am I gonna do? And he sat down and he wrote a play about the Zoot Suit riots, the racism that was happening in the courts, and the way that the news media portrayed this crime at the Sleepy Lagoon murder trial. When he wrote this play, he put it up for Chicano artists, for Chicano audiences, and they sold out for months. Well, in New York, they're not gonna let money go by, so they brought that play to New York. And that becomes, Zoot Suit becomes the first Chicano play to ever be on Broadway. Once it's done there, it comes back and they make a film out of it. Now, Luis Valdez had never made a movie before, so he filmed the stage play. It gets great critical reviews and it paves the way and begins all of Chicano cinema and even the career of Edward James Olmos. That's the film you guys are going to watch. I want you to pay attention to the themes, now the way that the story is being told, but also the main character of El Pachuco. Well, not the main character, he's the side character, the sidekick or the mentor. And El Pachuco is a character who no one else can see except for Henry Reyna, the main character. El Pachuco represents Chicano culture, all the good and the bad parts. He's also part of Henry. So sometimes he's Henry's brain, and sometimes he's just what the culture would say, right? So I want you to think about that while you're watching the film. There's a bunch of really cool things, and I can't wait to talk about them with you. So everyone, enjoy the film, and I'll see you on the other side.